Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. We suggest that you watch the video on plate tectonics before watching this video. We live in an amazing country with incredible geology. Let's apply our knowledge of plate tectonics to understand how some American mountains were made. In this video, we'll look at Mount Saint Helens in Washington State, volcanoes in Hawaii, the Rocky Mountains, and the Appalachian Mountains. This is Mount Saint Helens, the most famous American volcano. It is located in Washington State, in the northwest part of the continental U.S. It is on the western edge of the North American tectonic plate, with continental crust above that plate. To the west, there is a smaller tectonic plate called Juan de Fuca. For millions of years, the Juan de Fuca plate has been slowly subducting below the North American tectonic plate. As this happens, the North American plate develops small cracks through which magma can rise. When that magma builds up inside the continental crust, it can make a volcano-shaped mountain. And when that magma exits through the top of the mountain, we then call that magma lava and say the volcano is active. When the hot lava cools, it turns to rock, and that builds up the sides of the volcano, which makes it bigger. One such crack made Mount St. Helens less than 300,000 years ago. Geological timescales are usually in millions of years, so 300,000 years ago is considered relatively recent. Mount St. Helens had a major eruption in 1980, which is the biggest volcano eruption in American history. In this series of photos taken about 20 years ago, we can see part of Mount St. Helens getting larger. The rocks are getting bigger because there is magma below them. In this case, the magma did not break through the surface rocks, so the volcano did not erupt. Next, let's look at the Hawaiian Islands. These were all made by volcanoes, but yet there is no tectonic plate boundary near Hawaii. Geologists suspect that there is a local hot spot in the mantle below the tectonic plates. A hot spot is like a blowtorch, which can burn a hole in the tectonic plate and overlying oceanic crust. Then, magma pours through that hole from the mantle and later exits a volcano as lava. When that lava cools, it builds up the sides of the volcano. As the Pacific plate moves west, new oceanic crust goes over that hot spot and develops a hole, which then forms a new volcano. This is why the Hawaiian volcanoes are all in a row. The oldest Hawaiian island is in the northwest and is about 5 million years old. The newest one is in the southeast and is less than a million years old. Now let's look at the Rocky Mountains, which cover much of the western U.S. and Canada. Geologists have several advanced methods they can use to determine the age of rocks. Using those methods, geologists have determined that the Rocky Mountains are about 80 million years old. In geological timescales, this is considered recent. The tallest mountains in the world are less than 100 million years old. Geologists suspect about 200 million years ago, there was a large tectonic plate where much of the Pacific plate is now. That plate was called the Farallon Plate. About 80 million years ago, the Farallon Plate subducted under the North American Plate, and in the process lifted much of the western continental U.S. and created the Rocky Mountains. The Farallon Plate made a shallow angle below the North American Plate, which caused the mountains to rise much farther inland than usually happens with a convergent boundary. There are some small remnants of the plate in the northwestern U.S. and in Central America, but most of it is melting in the mantle deep below the North American Plate, as shown by the blue masses in this calculated computer model made by NASA. As with all parts of the Earth, there were many other events, but this is the primary one that made the Rocky Mountains. These are the Appalachian Mountains. They include the Blue Ridge, Catskill, and Great Smoky Mountains that cover most of the eastern part of the continental U.S. Using advanced techniques, geologists have determined that the Appalachian Mountains are about 300 million years old. They are shorter than the younger Rocky Mountains because with time, older mountains become shorter. In a separate video, we'll review how weathering and erosion can wear down rocks. Right now, there are no tectonic plate boundaries near the eastern coast of the continental U.S. But 300 million years ago, when these mountains were made, the continents were in a different location and orientation. In the prior video, we showed this animation of the supercontinent called Pangaea that existed about 200 million years ago. Over the last 200 million years, the continents have been spreading apart due to the tectonic plates that carry them. But 400 million years ago, Pangaea had not yet formed, So geologists think the land masses on Earth looked like this. Then about 300 million years ago, several masses had collided along the red horizontal line. Above the red line, land masses would become part of what we now call North America, Europe, and Russia. Below the red line, land masses would become part of many modern continents, including South America and Africa. The line marks a mountain-forming region from the collision of these masses. The top edge of the line would become parts of the Appalachian Mountains, in what is now the east coast of the U.S. The bottom edge of the line would become part of the Atlas Mountains, in what is now the north coast of Africa. Then, over the last 200 million years, the tectonic plates moved apart and took the continents and their mountains to nearly the opposite sides of the world. There have been many other events during that long time period, but that is the primary one that geologists suspect made the Appalachian Mountains. If you're interested in knowing about the theories on what makes the tectonic plates move, then please see our video about the Earth's interior. Here's a summary and some additional information about the topic we just covered. Please pause the video if you wish to read this. If you're interested in practice tests that are similar to state exams, but with detailed, colorful explanations for each answer, then please see our apps in the App Store. Many of these are free and none expire or limit their function. Since we only make educational products for children, none of our apps have third-party advertising, in-app purchasing, or connect to the internet. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.